Goodyear to infinity and beyond.
Oh man, you guys.
Wow.
You guys.
Look at that.
Battery power?
San Diego.
Okay, where are we? Here we are leaving Miami, Miami Beach. Actually, we're in Biscayne Bay, right, honey?
I guess. It's now 6:15. We're supposed to leave at 4, so we're about 2 hours late.
And
for some reason, we're moving in the opposite. Maybe that other cruise ship was coming in.
Yeah. And as you can see in the background, they're playing basketball. And maybe I can get a shot of Warren Moon, honey. Larry, do you think it would be rude?
Zoom around this way. And Warren Moon's on the treadmill. Maybe he'll wave to us.
No, you can't really see.
She zoomed by and zoomed
away. I didn't want to be rude.
Yeah.
This lens is awfully dirty. It has a whole bunch of green stuff on it.
I know, but is it green when you look through the lens?
Yes.
Well, that's okay, because you know what that means? If you can see the color, that means it's not on the front of the lens. That means it's on the eyepiece.
Oh.
Because you can only see black and white, right?
Right.
So it's okay. No big deal.
Okay.
Jeez. Bye.
Signing off. Goodbye, Miami, and hello, Virgin Islands.
Directions. At us over at the Fisherman's Pier.
Good position over here. And Dan, you guys, why don't you just pick a corner over here? I don't think you need to do any rouse right now, but John's gonna kind of head over to you and talk to you about what you're thinking of when you run patterns and what you're thinking of when you catch maybe some drills you do that might help the youngsters that are all catching.
Okay, so he does.
Remember, Desmond's a receiver. Desmond, while we saw him on the special teams, of course, spectacular year in special teams, by trade and profession, you're a receiver.
Eyes and was open for nothing.
That's right.
just a couple questions. What's the most difficult weather condition that you can play? Well, I would have to say, I play in the rain and the mud and the cold. And then there's a ball, and the ball's coming in the flight. It's shifting all over the place sometimes in the dust. And Lambeau Field and Rich Stadium, the two stadiums I've been in, Wills, and some dusty stadiums. See, that's nothing being a part of it. It's really a good thing. You just increase your chance of missing the ball. So I think the biggest thing to catch the ball, besides being all the drill and everything, is mentally, you have to know that you've got to catch the ball in there.
Offensive receiver. I mean, we got a guy in the league, and I don't. There's more than one of them that are always trying to push off and get advantage.
I know what I mean.
Trying to get advantages by doing that. So, he's mentioning one player, but believe me, every one of these guys knows exactly.
Never done it. Is it wind? Is it? God, you get snow up in Green Bay. You get all conditions up in Green Bay. What are the toughest conditions for you?
The toughest conditions would be a day like today. Going up when the air is high and fun, you'll probably go out there. So it's very hard to judge the ball when it's gusting winds. And like God, I said earlier, not only from a receiver standpoint, but
uh-oh. That's up down below.
Okay.
I just felt like running around.
Nice.
Woo! Nice.
Obviously, he's been proven everywhere he's gone. I think he has a unique way of motivating players. I think he understands players in a way that maybe some coaches don't. I think that's what he uses to his advantage. As far as time frame, I'm one who believes that it's got to be right away. It's got to be now. I mean, there's no reason why we can't turn things around. Next question.
You remember?
Oh yeah, yeah. All right. Well, it seems like every time I do anything, I have to answer the Al Davis question. So we'll just put it like this. Al Davis is, for all intents and purposes, he's done a lot. You can like the guy, you can dislike the guy, but he's done everything in this league, from being a commissioner to an owner to a scout to a coach. I mean, you got to respect what the guy has done. At the same time, players have their own opinion.
Going to practice, but overall, playing the rest of those teams and playing at a normal time during the day, 1 o'clock, 12 o'clock games, something like that. You get in at good times, and it's not that bad. You leave on Saturday, you get back right after the game, but it's just those games with, and these guys, I bet, can attest to that.
Thank you.
You can't see. picture, but then again.
Eclectic musical taste here this morning.
Does that mean Yanni's next?
Well, Kenny Gianna, I'll definitely be comatose.
That means you will not hear Barry Manilow this morning, folks.
You might want to mention that.
Working out on deck.
Leon and Troy are
right up the street, really.
Okay, I'll give him a break. Okay, your mark, get set, go!